On est belle place, il fait chaud.
J'aimerais ça prendre une
Verona.
Pour le site web.
OK.
So what's up, David? How you feeling, man?
Feeling great, feeling great.
Do you have to be better? Do you have to kill yourself to make weight, or is it easy at this point?
Do I look dead?
No, you look happy, you're smiling, you're laughing. You can't even tell you're fighting.
You know what? With every fight, I learn how my body works better and better, and it's becoming technically this fight is easier than even the one against Glenn Tapia. You know, I have a three pound extra, but even where I am right now, it's more easy than it was before the way I do things.
Everybody's saying you take care of business, Canelo takes care of business, you're fighting Canelo in September. I know you have a fight, you have Marco Antonio Reyes, but if you are fighting Canelo, what do you think?
It's definitely going to be up there, you know. He's a great fighter, and me, I'm there to fight the best. So once the time comes to fight Canelo, my arms are wide open. I don't say no to nobody. I consider myself beating these guys, and I don't... And they're going to fear me, not me fear them.
Do you think that Chavez is going to put up a stiff challenge for Canelo?
Definitely. Chavez is a great fighter. He's a big boy. He's, has a different style than Canelo, but he's a big boy. He's a strong guy. You know, he's a good fighter. You know, his dad's a legend. He's, you know, it's good. There's a lot of things to prove on his behalf coming in this fight also. So there's going to be that extra mental strength. I think it could be to his advantage.
And you know, you came into this camp almost right after the Stevens fight. Did you think that made it a lot easier to get in your rhythm for this fight? And where do you rate that knockout of Stevens?
Until now, except another fighter is going to kill another fighter, I think that's pretty much knockout of the year. You know, it was a perfect hook. I said it and I did it. You know, I told him it was going to be a spectacular knockout against him, and that's what I did. He put too much gas on the fire. You shouldn't do that against Lemieux.
And what about just getting right out of that fight and coming right into this one? Was it, you know, easier to get into the rhythm in camp?
You know, you're already on the wave, and that's why I took this fight. I wasn't injured. The health was, everything was perfect. I took 1 week off and I went right back in the gym, and we're here now today. This is a great opportunity. You know, all the fans are here. Vegas is a great fight city. The T-Mobile is a great scene we set up. And I love fighting here, and I love fighting, period. The opportunity came, and it's definitely said yes without hesitation.
Would you ever want a rematch with Triple G if that came up?
Definitely.
Why?
Because I know the adjustments to be made to be able to beat a guy like that. You know, he's a human being. He's a great fighter, but he's a human being. Everybody has weaknesses. Everybody has strengths. I know my strengths, and I have a lot of confidence in my strengths going in a fight against a guy like Triple G. So, never underestimating or never downgrading the guy. He's a great fighter. It will never be an easy fight against him, but he's beatable. So it's a challenge I give myself personally. I think the fans would love it in the near future when that fight came up, and me to prove to myself I'm the best. I can beat the best. I can do great things. It's things to prove.
Dave, did you see anything in the Jacobs-Golovkin fight that made you think I can incorporate this?
You know, I was in my camp during this time. I didn't even see the Jacobs and Golovkin fight. I saw clips of it, but I can't comment on that.
Did you think that fight came too soon for you as you look back at it?
No, I don't. I can't regret anything. I don't say it came too soon. I took it right away. I was ready to beat him. I was ready to... It's not about I was ready or not. It's about my adjustments that had to be made. And now I know what adjustments need to be made against a guy like that. So it's not that I wasn't ready or I was ready or I wasn't ready. It's about what I need to do, the adjustments that I need to take to beat a guy like that.
David, top five people in boxing that can knock someone out in one punch. So it's you and four more. Who would you add to that list? People that have one punch knockout artists.
Anthony Joshua.
Okay.
Matisse, he's a good big puncher. Pacquiao. always. Who else?
Wilder?
Wilder's a big puncher, definitely.
Mikey Garcia?
Garcia, Thurman, all big punchers.
And, Mikey Garcia's knockout with your knockout. Did you see his knockout?
No.
Zlatan Tanin.
Yeah. Oh, yeah? No, you can't top my knockout.
You had a crazy knockout. And Stevenson talked a lot before. Afterward, you guys hung out a little bit, right?
You hung out?
You squashed the beef a little bit?
No, we didn't hang out. No. He was okay, he came, but you know, Stevens, you know, it was a wake up call for him, that fight. He don't talk like that to any fighter, he got what he deserved. You know, this is 2017. You know, adjust with the time. You know, real professionals don't talk like that. They fight in the ring. The fight is in the ring. That's what you need to do.
Is that the most personal fight you've ever had in your career?
I think so. I think that's the most personal fight. Before that was a lesser guy, but he talked also, and I broke three of his ribs, his nose, took care of him too. But I guess it's an advantage if they talk, so it's an advantage for me. I get extra aggressive, so it's good. Keep talking, guys, you know.
Dave, it's very hard to sell out boxing arenas, very hard. You do it regular basis in Canada. Do you ever think you can sell out 90,000?
You know, that's very impressive, especially now in 2017, where most of the fights people don't want to get out of their comfort. They want to stay at home and watch the fights. But you know, English fans, man, they just go out. They love to go out and support their guys. I love seeing that. This is what the Mexicans do. The Mexicans do it. They get out and support instead of staying at the TV inside. Fill up the stadiums. Yeah, I would love to do it me one day. Hopefully with all the Quebec fans filling up the stadiums.
You and Canelo?
Yes. In due time, of course.
Alright, there you have it. Thanks, Dave.
Any last message you want to tell the fans out there?
Watch this fight. It's gonna be another great performance from my side. And a great weekend of boxing.
Well, thank you very much. Good
luck.
On Espanol?
I just want to see you knock out Conor McGregor.
McGregor? He's not a boxer.
Yeah. He wants to box.
UFC, yeah. Come on, man.
Too easy.
Easy. Nothing's easy, but he's not a boxer. He's a great UFC fighter, but the boxing is a different world.
There you have it. FaceTV.com. Alex, great reporting. So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. FaceNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekpak, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Ellie Sekpak.